right, so we're gonna start talking about data entry. Up to this point, everything we talked about was shared between systematic reviews and meta-analysis projects. After this point, however, what we're talking about is mostly built for meta-analysis projects. Now, if you are in fact doing a meta-analysis, we're very excited to help you, because what we will offer after this point is rarely found anywhere else. Let's see how HubMeta can help you to do your data entry, your meta-analysis. All right, so I'll open up my project and go right into my data entry. These are, of course, papers that have been accepted after full text screening. The page itself looks pretty much like all other pages we have on HubMeta, and you have filters, but of course, the options you have in filters are more complete, and it's not very difficult to figure out how to work with our filters, so I'm not going to talk about that. One thing we need to explain here is that our data entry page is built for correlational meta-analysis as of this moment. What this means is that our data entry page works best in cases where you want to grab a correlation matrix from your studies and enter them into HubMeta, and then you will do a correlational meta-analysis in the end. Let's see how we will do that. If you open up any paper, you will see it's empty for now. You have to first create a sample. You can just call it sample one, or let's say, for example, students in grade two. This is the size of your sample, of course, very important variable. Here you can determine if in the correlation table from your study you have R-score, like a Pearson correlation, or other types of scores that can be converted to a correlation, like a D-score, F-score, T-score, chi-square. In which case, if you choose any of these, HubMeta will automatically do conversion calculations for you. For now, I will leave this calculation type blank. I will explain this later in another video when we will talk about composite scores. Now, this data entry page might look a little bit like a pilot's cabin. And especially if you open up this advanced mode, there are a lot of different things that you can enter here, but it's actually very easy to work with. You will completely figure it out the first time you work with it. So very quickly, starting from the top, if you click on this, the PDF for the file you're working on will open up for you. Here you have some further info about the file. And here is also where you can work on automatic import, which I will explain later. This will provide a history of whoever has worked on the file and what changes they have made. And if you need to contact the authors of this paper, you will add a note right here. So coming back to the correlations page, here you can add different rows. Like for example, if you have three variables, you can choose to work with them here, and you can enter values here in the correlation table, and here you can enter values for mean, standard deviation, and Cronbach alpha. With this, you have the option to toggle between simple and advanced mode. In the advanced mode, you have options to enter mean, max, and determine if this was a reversed scale or an aggregated scale, and what was the number of items, or if it's a binary variable, what was the percentage of a split, or if this variable was dichotomous or dichotomized. These are very specific choices for specific types of projects, especially if you're doing a mean-based meta-analysis rather than correlation-based meta-analysis. But for most cases, we'll just work with the simple option. So quickly, this is the correlation table. Here you will choose your variables. Here are more details about your sample. This is the sample size, the type of score, and you can add further notes down here. And down here are different moderator variables that you have set up for your project. Now, the first time you set up your project, it comes with a bunch of default moderator variables, which you can, of course, edit here in taxonomy, which I will explain in another video. Now, let's take a look at a complete data entry page from one of my previous projects. As you can see, this is the correlation table for my project. And these are the ones that we have attached to existing variables in my project. And these last two, which are grayed out, are calculated composite scores. So these are calculated by HubMeta. Check composite scores calculation video to understand how this is done. This is my sample size. This is some further notes that people have added. And of course, these are my moderator variables and, you know, all the different options that I have in selecting them. And if I make any changes here, I can either save that specific part or do save all. Now let's take a closer look at each of these big parts in the next videos.